Speaking of Alan, let's check in with him right now.
Let's go.
Watching the storm minute by minute, mile by mile. As we get closer to midnight, here's a view from Pensacola, downtown Pensacola, powered by Unity Fiber. You're looking out toward Pensacola Beach. You can actually see the lights in the distance. It tells you it's not raining that hard there, at least at the moment. Here at News 5, we picked up over 2.5 inches of rain. Our temperature sits in the mid-70s. But talk about the wind. They're picking up now more and more. Inland communities along Highway 84, your winds 5 to 10 miles an hour, but coastal counties, steady winds between 20 and 25. But talk about wind gusts, that's the burst of wind that goes away after a few minutes. 22 mile an hour wind gust in Leakesville, 13 for those of you in Calvert, and then along our coastline, anywhere from 28 to 38 miles per hour. All of that will continue to increase as the eye of Hurricane Nate moves onshore across the Mississippi coast in the next hour or next couple of hours. We have many threats to watch out for, and each one is going to depend upon where you live. One thing that we do talk about a lot is the tide levels. And since earlier this evening, we've seen the tide levels coming up steadily. 4.2 feet Dog River, 5 feet in Bayou La Batre, 4 feet at Dauphin Island, Pascagoula, Fowl River, 4.5. And then in the Mobile State Docks, 3.5, approaching 4. Now, this has been a steady increase in the tide levels based on the steady east to southeast wind we've seen for most of the day. But as this system gets close to land, there will likely be a surge as the wind shift and the winds really pick up. Earlier this morning, Fowl River. This afternoon, Fowl River. Water just going up. Now we are approaching high tide, which will be the middle of the night. So places like Fish River, you still have a ways to go. That water is going up. And again, depending upon which way the wind is blowing, you're going to have to watch out for that threat of seeing even higher tide levels. Latest satellite, latest position. These blue lines are 60 miles across, so Nate is not too far from making a second landfall on the Mississippi Gulf Coast. Winds 85 miles an hour, which is where they've been for most of the evening. Because it's so close to land, it doesn't have time to really strengthen much, which we don't want it to. It may actually weaken a little bit and still steadily moving northward at 20 miles an hour. The hurricane force winds, they go out about 30 to 40 miles. So in other words, if you're just talking near the eye, the hurricane force winds wouldn't make it directly to the Mississippi-Alabama state line. But that's a little deceiving because tropical storm force winds, they can be 60, 70 miles an hour. So just because the eye may be pretty far away from you in Gulf Shores or in Milton, Florida, or from Monroeville, we're still going to see bands of rain. Here's a projection through the night. Winds that have been eastward become southeastward going into the middle of the night. The winds also increase, and that's what's going to push the surge of water farther inland across the coast and farther up into the rivers and especially into the bays. 1 a.m. scattered thunderstorms, still feeder bands outside the core of the storm. Strongest winds likely along the coastline of Mississippi, George County, Greene County, for example, around that eye wall, which may not be a full circle, but somewhere there, that's where you would tend to see the hurricane force winds. But look at this by 4 a.m. Look how many bright colors there are in Washington County, northern Baldwin County, back into the Florida Panhandle. This would be that very heavy rain that many of us have not seen yet. We've seen moderate rain. We've seen some heavy rain, but it's going to get heavier moving through the night. And note the bands of rain extending out into the Gulf and down into the Gulf. Those are feeder bands that will still bring a threat of tornado. So these are all the things we're dealing with as we move through the night. Most of this is going to be less active as we get into tomorrow morning. The afternoon, weather-wise, looks better, but still we might be dealing with cleanup from trees down, power lines down, people without electricity. So the day looks better, not necessarily perfect, and that's something that we're all going to get prepared for.